Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will be talking about chi-square goodness of fit test. It tests the hypothesis that an observed frequency distribution fits some claimed distribution. It uses categorical data and the experiment is multinomial. We're going to be looking at the following example. The posted grade distribution guidelines for a statistics course is 9% A, 33% B, 38% C, 14% D, and 6% F. A sample of 200 statistics grades from the previous semester showed 24 A's, 60 B's, 70 C's, 30 D's, and 16 F's. We're supposed to assess the claim. Actual grades deviate significantly from the posted grade distribution guideline. We're supposed to test at a level of significance of 5%. The first thing for us is to write down the null and the alternative hypothesis. The null hypothesis is P1 is equal to 0.09, P2 is equal to 0.33, P3 is equal to 0.38, P4 is equal to 0.14, and P5 is equal to 0.06, where these proportions represent the proportions for A, B, C, D, and F, respectively. The alternative states at least one of the PIs is not equal to the specified value. This will be our claim in this case. Now, to be able to do this, I will be using Excel to get our test statistic and other values that we need. So we're going to be going on to Excel. So we have our Excel page right here. In the first column, we have the observed frequencies. That's from the sample of 200 students. In the second column, we're going to be computing the expected frequency. So in the first cell, I will be multiplying the proportion of A's from the guidelines with my N, which in this case is 200. And I'm going to do that respectively for each of the grades. So for the first cell, I have 0.09, that is the proportion for A's, multiplied by N. In the second cell, I have 0.33. multiplied by 200. In the third cell, I have 0.38 multiplied by 200. In the next cell, I have 0.14 multiplied by 200. And lastly, I have equal to 0.06 multiplied by 200. Now, the next thing I'll notice, if I take a sum of this column, it must also add up to my N, which in this case is 200. So I took a sum here, hit enter, I have 200. The next thing I'm working up to computing using the formula, in this cell, I'm going to be taking the difference between the observed frequency minus the expected frequency. I'll repeat that for all of the cells. So I simply drag down in Excel. Again, you notice if I take the sum or the total for this column, it must come to zero. And lastly, I'm going to, again, use the formula. I'm going to be taking, I'm going to start with two parentheses. This will be observed minus expected. I'll close that parentheses. Raise to the power of 2, and then I'll close it again, and then divide by the expected frequency. Then I'll compute for all of the cells, but I'll just drag down. And lastly, I'll be taking a sum of that column. So what I'm working up to is the formula that I'm going to be showing you again in a minute. So this will be the value of my test statistic. So that will be what I'll be using as my test statistic. The other value I need will be my critical value, my chi-squared critical value. So I could either use a chi-squared table by finding the area on the right tail and then the degrees of freedom. Now, the degrees of freedom in this question is k minus 1. My k is 5 because I have 5 possible outcomes. So my degrees of freedom is k minus 1, which is 4. So to be able to find the critical value, I'll either use the table or I'll go to Excel, any cell in Excel, and type chi-square is going to show up, chi-square.inv, it's a right tail test. And then I'm going to put in the probability, which in this case is 5%, and then the degrees of freedom, and then I'll press enter. So this returns my critical value. Now, lastly, I'm going to be finding the p-value. So to be able to find the value, I'll go to any cell and type chi-square.dist.rt, and then I'm going to put in my test statistic, which is right here, comma, the degrees of freedom, again, which is 4. So this becomes my p-value. So these are the results that I'm going to be using to, these are the results I'll be using to test the hypothesis. So I'll go back to the table here, and then from the results, I'm going to go ahead and perform the test. The critical value we obtained from Excel, 9.488, and then we compare that to the test statistic, which is 4.495. The test statistic is less than the critical value. This is a right tail test, so the test statistic falls outside the rejection region. I can also make the same decision by comparing my p-value, which we also obtained from Excel as 0.34, to alpha, which is 0.05. My p-value is greater than my alpha, therefore I fail to reject the null hypothesis. We can thus conclude that at 5% level of significance, we do not have sufficient evidence to support the claim. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you in the next video.